Hello, Leo. Welcome to your February 2021 love reading. What's going on? Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Leo. It is general. Keep that in mind. So if it doesn't resonate, check out your moon or your rising sign. If it does resonate, the link to the extended reading is below where you can check out how your person truly feels about you, what's going on in their everyday life. Kind of a little sneak peek, Leo. And if y'all need a private reading, all my info is below. Make sure you subscribe to the channel if you like and hit that notification bell so that you are notified when I upload weekly. All right, Leo, let's see what your love life looks like. February, coming into the current moment, we have the world. Reaching milestones, right? Reaching goals. What's the challenge or the influence? It's the Emperor. So two majors, Aries energy. What's on your mind, Leo? It's the Four of Coins in reverse. What happened in the recent past? We have the Hermit, Virgo energy. Situation, why is it all happening? The Hanged Man in reverse. Look at all these major arcana. Big month for Leo for February. So this is why everything's going down. Hanged Man in reverse. Could be dealing with someone who's a little bit stubborn, kind of refuses to see things in a new light. And this is also, you know, just no longer waiting around, no longer in suspension, kind of releasing. Coming into the near future, what will you experience? The Four of Cups. How do you see yourself right now? What are you up to? Ooh, Leo, the Ten of Swords. What? All right, you guys. In your environment headed in, what's coming? You've got the Two of Coins. What's going on in your emotions? The Nine of Wands. You guys are tired. Yeah. Outcome, what do we have? We have the Fool. So, you know, beginning again. Definitely cycles ending and new beginnings coming. You've got Aries energy. Some of you are definitely dealing with an Aries. I thought I saw, yep, and we've got the Emperor here, Aries energy. All right. All right, Leo, let's see what's going on. Again, the reading's happening, or, you know, what's in the foundation here is that Hanged Man in reverse. So just, again, no longer kind of waiting around. You're releasing. You're letting go. You've got the Four of Coins in reverse on your mind. You've got the World here, which is ending a cycle. The Ten of Swords, Gemini energy. All right, show me Leo. What do they need to know about February 2021? Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus for Leo in love. Show me Leo's energy. Somebody ghosted or withdrew here in the recent past. Virgo energy with that Hermit. And, you know, the thing about the Hermit, too, is, yeah, it's withdrawal or, you know, pulling away, something like that, disappearing. But it's also enlightenment. It's because you need to figure some stuff out, right? He's got that lantern. He's very wise energy, very slow energy. But it is withdrawal. So let's see. That Hermit's trying to figure something out. All right, coming in right now, we have the World. So what's this about for Leo? What's this World energy? The Three of Pentacles in reverse. You just can't agree. Threes come out in reverse. It's a disagreement. It's a breakup, or it's just not being able to kind of have that teamwork to collaborate. So you're ending something. And it's on the tangible side, right? The value with the Pentacles. So it could be that you were just connecting with someone who you guys just weren't on the same page. It's kind of, you know, again, the World has been there, done that. Like, we've gone as far as we can go. What's influencing this is the Emperor. What's this about? The Strength card. There you are. Major Arcana for Leo and the Upright. Strong energy. The Emperor with the Strength card is bossing up. It's regaining your power, setting some boundaries, and really taming your actions. Very mature, very strong energy. And it's kind of like, it is what it is, coming into the current moment, is what that feels like to me. In the past, you have the Hermit. What's this about? You got the World there. The Four of Cups. Yeah, just not being fulfilled, being kind of bored. You know, it's kind of meh. And so somebody kind of just isolated and pulled away. Maybe there was a lack of expressing the complacency or the feeling of this just isn't cutting it. Four of Cups. And you have the Page of Cups. Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. Kind of immature, right? It's a page and you want kings or queens, depending. It's just energy, but what's this Page of Cups? Somebody wanted to fulfill a dream here. Yeah, and then an Emperor. Aries energy. You or the other person, Leo, could be kind of a boss, right? You own your own business or you have a high-ranking position at work. You're fulfilling a dream. And there's a connection here that just wasn't quite cutting it. You know, I don't feel like this is necessarily long term. This is more maybe somebody you were just casually talking to or dating, something like that. And there's something that's more important, somebody realized in the past. Because on your mind is this Four of Coins in reverse. This is letting go of something that maybe you at one point saw some value. Yeah, and just moving forward with the Chariot, Sign of Cancer, the Water Uber. You, and outside of love, Leo, what I'm seeing and feeling here is you have a lot of success and you have a goal that you're going towards. And if somebody here just, you know, you're not on the same page, that Chariot is really fast energy. It's moving forward towards success. And the reason it's all happening is the Hanged Man in reverse could be dealing with somebody that just couldn't quite understand other things that you're manifesting in your life. Hanged Man in reverse. Yeah, the Ten of Wands. A lot of burdens, a lot of pressure, a lot going on. We have two tens of the world. I mean, this cycle's definitely shutting out. And the Ten of Wands, why is this here? The Queen of Swords. Libra, Gemini, Aquarius energy. And you're being very logistical about it. Whether you're a male or female, I think that Queen of Swords is your energy. Having to detach, being truthful about it, but just saying, okay, that's it. And then moving on. Here's the ultimatum. I've got a lot going on in my life. If you're not on board, see ya. I feel strong disagreements here, more so than like cheating and betrayal and all that kind of stuff. Coming into the near future, you'll experience this Four of Cups, which is Cancerian energy, and the Five of Cups. Yeah, Scorpio, that water, all that water, emotional, right? I don't think that you or the other person are, you know, overly happy about this. But with that Five of Cups, this is kind of looking back and being regretful. Like, man, but again, it's that energy of, God, I wish that had worked out, but it's just not filling my cup. This is Five of Cups. Yeah, because of the Ten of Pentacles. Money, stability within the home, building a legacy, building a lot of security in your life. And again, for some of you, it's not even love. It's job or money or family or something like that. Bad timing is what I'm getting here in love with somebody. You see yourself as just ending it. And, you know, and the Ten of Swords is overkill. It's like, I can't take another sword. I got too much going on. What's this Ten of Swords for Leo? Yeah, the Empress. Libra, Taurus energy. Because of what? The Empress is abundant. The Empress is giving birth to something new. There's a lot of expansion. You've got it on your mind and you see yourself here. But unfortunately, somebody feels a little bit hurt or something just didn't work out because of this new beginning with the Empress. This beautiful, very fertile energy that, you know, is success. Coming in from your environment, you have a Two of Coins and the Death card, Scorpio. This is the person you are connecting with. They kind of wishy-washy. They go back and forth, right? Maybe I should end it with Leo. I've got a lot going on. They've got a lot going on, but I don't really know what to do because I do feel a connection. And that's why you'll experience this disappointment and sad. I do feel like you'll miss this person a little bit. Why is the Two of Coins and the Death card external coming in? Because of the Page of Pentacles. This person will still try to kind of keep a friendship with you. They value you, but it's very small. It's very slow, a little bit boring, right? Because it's going to take them some time to kind of phase out of this energy. And by the way, this could be anything going on in your life, Leo. It doesn't have to be a job or money or business or something like that. The main point is in love, there's a focus somewhere else. And there's a little bit of regret and disappointment about it, but you both are being mature about it. It's just like, again, this has gone as far as it can go. But expect that this person will, they'll waver. They'll go back and forth about ending it. They don't want to completely end it with you, but they don't want to give it a lot of time. It's like Page of Pentacles energy, right? So just know that. Now, in your emotions, you're the Nine of Wands. So again, close to completing a cycle, that Nine of Wands is tired, resilient though. Pushes forward, just kind of waiting because of the Seven of Pentacles in reverse due to a lack of investment, due to some disappointment. again, I was saying earlier, I don't think anybody's overly ecstatic about this connection not moving forward. But in your emotions, you're like, listen, I'm the Nine of Wands. I'm the Wounded Warrior. Been there, done that. And I have to just kind of keep pushing forward, although there is some disappointment with that Seven of Pentacles in reverse and the Eight of Wands in reverse, because you know that there's just no change, right? It's very stagnant energy. You feel that you can't manifest this connection. And with that Eight of Wands in reverse, I'm not really getting a block in communication. I don't see you blocking this person. I see it kind of just fading into the sunset. Do you know? And I think they're going to try for a little while. And then you've got the Page of Wands in reverse that just fell out, which is, you know, a lack of communication. It's a little bit lackluster, right? And it's because of having to deliver some not so great news. And I think that the communication just slowly kind of dies out, because the outcome for Leo here is the Fool. So Aries energy, this is a new beginning. This is brand new. Endings of cycles and then a new beginning in your outcome. Taking a risk, taking that leap of faith in a new direction. Why is this Fool here in the outcome for Leo? And the Four of Swords. And withdraw. I mean, look at the Four of Swords. She's like sleeping. Right? So this is very, the Four is all about stability. It's just taking a minute. And remember I said here, I kind of see a slow manifestation of just withdrawal and pulling away, and it becomes less and less and less. You know those relationships. That's what this is. And you'll find, because you have some new adventure going here, because you have great new beginnings and new paths that you're taking with that Fool energy, there's withdrawal with this person, kind of sleeping on it. What's this Four of Swords? But there's a dream you're fulfilling with the Star, Aquarian energy. It's a great month for Leo as far as your own goals, your aspirations, whatever that is, business, whatever that is to you. But love and this person is having to take a back seat to that. And I think you'll find they'll understand. Why is this Page of Pentacles external though? What's this Page of Pentacles? The Nine of Swords. They're gonna be thinking about it for a while. And that's why they keep going, they'll keep going back and forth with that Two of Coins on the ending. Maybe I could have done this for Leo. Maybe I could have been more supportive. Maybe I should have given them more space. Let me reach out. That Page of Pentacles would be like, hey, how about that weather? You know, and then it's like, oh, Leo's busy. I'm not hearing back from them. Nine of Swords. It's kind of that is what I'm getting with this reading. You've got a King of Cups at the bottom of the deck and the Hierophant. I think this person saw this evolving to something much more serious, like down the road, if whatever this is hadn't gotten, you know, hadn't become an issue or something else didn't get in the way. So this is not a reading of, oh, your ex screwed you over. Oh, deception, lie, secrets. Not getting it on this reading. This is more a reading of, again, you know, you or this other person having to kind of pull away from this energy to go towards something that's very fulfilling. It'd be interesting, you know, pull away, do this, whatever. And then what about in like 6 or 9 months? I mean, it's interesting that this energy was at the bottom of the deck. This may not be over forever, but this is what you can expect in February, Leo. All right, let's head over to the extended reading and we're going to dive in and we're going to see what they think about this new beginning. Do they feel like you'll come back? Do they feel like they want to wait on you? How will they kind of act here in February? What's on their mind? How do they truly feel? Because this looks pretty serious. All right, so let's head on over. All right, Leo, I am loving you hard. Love me hard back. And we'll speak soon. Take care.